I just want to appreciate the crowd that came out, all the attendance. We had a student section day before Thanksgiving. I think we got a nice, safe plan by the administration. I really appreciate everybody kind of embracing the mask rule. Obviously, a unique night, right? Kind of a different scene for college basketball. But I think as the game went on, we had a home court advantage because we had some really loyal fans come out tonight. So if you guys wouldn't mind helping me spread the word, you know, tickets are available for the second game. We play against a team that's picked to win their conference, Sam Houston State, at 1 o'clock on Friday. Tickets are available. I think everybody would agree that we had a nice, safe setup tonight. Just hoping we can get even more people to game on Friday.
Nathan, are you good now? Got a question?
Any chances you want to give, Nathan, Wes, y'all?
All right, let's go, Carlos.
Chris, I guess with everything considered that's kind of gone throughout the offseason, when you kind of look at the stat sheet and see 10 turnovers, what does that tell you about your guys and the way they were able to kind of really kind of play really good basketball today in terms of just smart, not turning the ball over a lot?
Yeah, I thought, Carlos, we were cognitive of our objective. You know, there's things you got to get done within the game to win the game. One of those is the turnover battle for us. But I wasn't pleased really with the execution. You know, I thought we could have easily had a 5-6 turnover game out there. We had a couple of our more experienced players with a couple just mistakes that I know they'd like to get back. But I think to keep it at 10, playing that many young new guys at the end is a positive. But you guys know me. I'm not going to be satisfied until I think it's at a level where we can really, really compete.
Five guys in double figures, including your starters. I know you talk about that balance, but what did you see from the guys when the lead was about 6 and then you went on that 29-7 run to close out the half?
Yeah, I thought the first half we just weren't trusting each other enough. We were having a lot of 1-2 pass possessions on offense. Not necessarily bad shots, but not championship basketball. First couple timeouts, guys did a great job at taking the adjustments. We slowed down, got the ball swinging a little bit better, and ended up having a nice offensive half. First half, I think we shot 56% from the field. So the balance is what we're looking for. A lot of unselfish plays out there tonight on offense. A lot of aggressive plays on defense. Obviously, a lot to clean up, but a good start.
Last one for me. I know it was kind of obvious there. Kevin McCullough on crutches. I guess what's the update you can give on him? Is it a long-term deal or is it short-term?
Yeah, Kev rolled an ankle. Certainly disappointed for him and our team, but pleased that it's something we're going to be able to get under control. You know, I would tell you this. Kev had his well – or as good of an offseason as I've seen in my years of college basketball. You guys know I really don't think in terms of like starting lineup, but we change that thing from time to time. But Kev was going to start this game, the first game of his sophomore season. He'd earned the right to do that. So I was disappointed in this adversity, but in no way will it define him. We've got the best trainer in college basketball in Mike Neal, and we'll get to work quickly, and he'll be back sooner than later. But it's an ankle issue with Kev. Thought he did a great job tonight being engaged on the bench. It's kind of special when you see guys like Namari and Micah, Booz on those guys come off the floor and look for Kev for advice. Kev's going to be a special player, and we'll get him back soon.
Yeah, Coach, you actually brought up Micah. Just what do you think about his tonight and his debut as a Red Raider?
Yeah, before watching the film, I thought he was dialed in. It was nice to see all those young guys out there get comfortable as the game go on. I didn't see many nerves or kind of young mistakes. I saw some inexperience, but I saw guys being aggressive. You know, Micah got the ball around the basket a lot with his talent tonight. Just needs to learn how to finish. You know, the shots that got away with it at a different level, kind of the hope shots, as we call them, you got to gather in here in a college game and really demand the right to finish. But certainly he did a lot of things with his talent tonight on both ends. It was great to see all those young guys out there getting Reek in the game, Namari, certainly Buzo, and then Micah. To get those freshmen in the game tonight was good experience for our team.
Just a couple more. What's the status of Vlad? I saw a wrist brace on his wrist there.
Yeah, same type thing with Kev. Vlad has an issue with his hand that we're just going to have to deal with. I know you guys like the medical reports here in Lubbock. I'm not the doctor. I don't know if we're talking day-to-day or week-to-week, but those guys will be back there as soon as they're 100% cleared by Mike Neal and the doctors. They'll be back. Neither one of them should be a long-term injury.
And these guys, a lot of new faces on this team, a lot of young players. The 22 assists just kind of shows how unselfish this team is.
I agree. Yeah, that's what we're looking for. Unselfish basketball. And tonight there was a lot of good assists out there. That's probably one of the top two or three things I saw in the game. I was most proud of it. Told the guys that after the game in the locker room.
Collier, do you have anything still?
Sure. Yeah, Coach. Can you? What did you think of Marcus's debut with the team?
I like everything about Marcus. Not even talking about the stat sheet. I like that he's the first guy in the gym tonight. I like that he had energy this morning. He was texting me and teammates last night about the game plan. And the guy's a winner. He'll win a lot of games in college basketball. He'll win a lot of games in pro basketball. Then he'll win a lot of games in life after basketball. He gets it. He's somebody I trust, and that's a strong statement, you know, when you coach the guy one game. But basketball-wise, you know, you guys have to do the stats and stuff. But there probably hasn't been too many Texas Tech debuts where a guy gets 12 rebounds in 18 minutes. So if he plays his normal minutes tonight, he probably breaks a Texas Tech rebounding record. But I'm glad I'm Marcus's coach.
All right, we'll finish up. One more question to Ronald.
You touched on it a little bit, but obviously the question coming into this season with, you know, a lot of transfers and things like that was how well was this team going to gel on the court? Obviously, you know, multiple people in double figures, you got all the assists that you guys had tonight. Is this something that you expect to see, you know, on a nightly basis, or was this just, you know, the starting point basically for that?
No, I do expect it. That word expectations is everything. That's absolutely what I expect. I expect these guys to play Texas Tech basketball. I expect them to defend with purpose and pride. I expect them to trust their teammates on offense and play unselfish March basketball. And I expect us to take a couple of bumps along the way because we're an inexperienced kind of young team in ways, but it's a long journey. But I do expect that. I expect these guys to put themselves in a position to win every game on the schedule. And tonight we got that done. And, you know, winning never gets old. I wanted to, you know, recognize Northwestern State, everything they had to do to get to Lubbock in terms of the travel and the COVID test. We had great communication with that coaching staff over the last weeks. We wish those guys a lot of luck tonight. I know it was a hard, long road trip for them. And we were fortunate tonight. They got a lot of great shots. The ball wasn't going in for them a lot consistently, but this game could have been totally different on the scoreboard. But I want to wish those guys a lot of luck this year too, because that's the kind of people you want to associate yourself with is guys like that that have class, and wish those guys the best this season.
Marcus, I guess first and foremost, obviously everyone was kind of looking to you to kind of be that rebounding start. I guess how did you feel you played today, and how did you feel the rest of the team kind of pushed together to kind of get those rebounds today?
It was great finally playing the Texas Tech uniform and playing with my brothers. We've been working so hard and been through so much with the whole COVID and all the other stuff that's going on. It just felt great to be out there and just competing with each other.
Mac, I guess just in terms of what you were able to accomplish today, obviously everyone's going to look at your final stat line, but at one point in the first half, you guys were only up by six, and then you guys kind of started that big run. What do you feel kind of led you all to kind of get on that big run?
You know, I think we just kind of trusted the offense more and kind of just settled in a little bit. When we run our motion, it usually works a lot, and we have our patience and trust in each other. So I think that's what sparked it.
As a reminder, raise your hand if you have a question. I'll throw it to Brandon Solis. Do you have anything?
Yeah, just kind of for both of you, I guess, Mac, you can go first. The freshmen that played, it looks like everybody's just kind of unselfish out there. Can you just talk about the young guys and how you've seen them kind of grow through this weird offseason?
Yeah, this has been a weird offseason, but we're not really using any excuses. But those guys, you know, they run their own race, as Coach says. They're very special dudes, and they're very coachable. You know, that's the biggest thing I see with these guys is, you know, their mind and how they, you know, just take the coaching, and they're level-headed. So I think that's the biggest thing with them. They have, obviously, the talent everyone sees.
Ronald, you have
a
question?
Same question. Yeah. Good.
Obviously, a lot of you guys are sort of, you know, new to the team, especially to you two guys. But the question coming in for this team was, how good were you guys going to be able to gel on the court? Is this just the start for you guys, or is this something that we should expect to see all season?
Definitely something you guys should expect all season. Where we always, I think, just us gelling is from loving each other and being close to each other on the court and especially off the court. Like, if you see one of us, we always have another teammate with us, and we're always hanging out with each other. So we wasn't surprised about how we was going to gel, but it was really good today.
All do you have a question?
Here we go. For both of you guys, five players in double figures, how do you feel like you guys balance the substitutions tonight and just getting everybody involved in the game?
Yeah, that's Coach Adams. You know, that's his plan, and we trust him and Coach Beard, so we just kind of follow their lead and go with that.
Yeah, like the whole subbing, we know if we're getting subbed out, it's because we did something wrong on defense. So it's just they're having us at a high expectation, so we know that we can't let nothing easy go out on defense.
Ryan Mingle, you have a question? Nathan, final question. We'll let the players get back to the locker room. So one more question, Nathan. You're on mute, man. All right, Carlos, can you finish it up? One more question.
Hey, Mac, I guess just when you guys kind of consider all the things that have kind of happened throughout the offseason, I guess when you kind of look at the stat of 10 turnovers, what does that kind of tell you all about the way you took care of the ball tonight?
Yeah, 10 turnovers or less is what we want every single night. And, you know, that's what you have to do to win, and that's what we believe in. So I think that's very important to us, and we take a lot of value in that.